Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome back to another episode of Honda Street Garage. And again, we're doing another transmission, this time B-Series. We're going to show you how to tear down and put it back together, basically. We're going to replace the third gear synchro. So if you need to replace your third gear synchro because you got to grind, that's what we're going to be doing on this transmission today. So a lot of tech-fueled stuff. So pay attention and here we go. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here we have a B16 S4C transmission. Pretty much identical to the S80 transmissions for the LS, the GSR, and the Type R. They're not exactly the same, but they're pretty much the same to work on. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. Today we're replacing the third gear synchro. So working on this transmission, a lot of it is the same for D-series transmissions. Also, pretty much the same process. Okay, the first thing we're gonna do is pull this out. Just use the half inch screwdriver. It's already loose because we've opened this transmission before and we were gonna replace the third gear synchro and now we can. So you'll see inside of here, the little ring that we need to split apart. All right, here's pretty much the tools you're gonna need. Half inch ratchet, then a 3/4 ratchet, but I'm gonna be using the impact gun. You're gonna need a 14 millimeter socket, a 12 millimeter socket, a 10 millimeter socket, a screwdriver that's small enough to fit through the shift linkage thing, flathead screwdriver. I got a magnet, some pliers, and a hammer. It should be relatively easy to get this apart. Also, we have a box here on the side where we can put all of our parts. Make sure you do this. That way, when you go to put it back together, all the bolts and everything are where they need to be and you don't have extra ones left over. So that's the first one we're gonna put in there from here. Now the next step is gonna be pulling these two 12 millimeter detents out. And when we take this off, there should be a little spring that comes out with it. I'm gonna put that in the box. There should be a little ball in there. You can see it in there. Now we're gonna use our magnet. There you go. You can pop the shift linkage, a little ball will come out. So we're gonna take that little ball and put it in the box. Next one, should be a spring behind it, washer. I'm gonna stick the screwdriver in the shifter. It should kind of shoot out. And there's the ball. Put the ball in the box. Now on the top side of the transmission, we're gonna take this 14 millimeter bolt out. It's what holds the reverse gear in. Bolt out with its washer, throw in the box. Now we're gonna pull the 12 millimeter bolts out. Now we're gonna try to pry the casing open a little bit. The best place to start prying is right here on the front. Okay, now that we've got the seal broken, normally it may not be that easy because this transmission's been taken apart. So now we're gonna come over here to the little pin lock ring. We're gonna take these pliers, pry that apart. Okay, now we can pry up on the, we're gonna pry up on the transmission again. And there we go, it has dropped down. And now the case should lift right off. There we go. Now when I took the casing off, there's a bearing still in there. That needs to come out. That should have stayed on top of the gear set. Just take the soft pad, drop it, comes right out. Now this bearing goes right on top of here. Remember the words should face up. There you go, should just, should just pop on and off, honestly. Okay, so here is the inside of the transmission. This is the countershaft, main shaft, and differential. I'm not sure if I have these two backwards, but you get the idea. This transmission actually has a coif LSD limited slip differential in it. This transmission is good, except for it's got a third gear grind. It's pretty chewed up. So now that we have it open, the case off, first thing we're going to do is remove this piece right here. It's got 2 10-millimeter bolts. All right, what I like to do is when I pull this piece off, I like to put the two bolts back in it and keep those two bolts with that part. But I'm going to put it in the box, just, you know, leave the bolts in it. Now we have to get the shift selector out. There is 3 10-millimeter bolts, and there's one right here that's gold colored, I guess, or brass. That one goes into this corner right here, and I think that's just because it's shorter. There's a third one hiding right in there. We're gonna pull the bolts out. And this third one is usually a pain to kind of lift out, so once again, we're gonna use the magnet and pull the bolt out. All right, so now this whole thing should lift out. You gotta wiggle it a little bit. But once again, I'm gonna put the bolts back in everything and set it in the box. All right, so I put the bolts back in it where they go. I'm just gonna set it down in the box. So those bolts stay with that. Now we're gonna lift out reverse, just like the K-Series transmission. You'll notice there's a lot of similarities with this transmission and the K-Series. Lift this whole piece out. It's kind of tricky because it's slippery. But it has this little keyway right here, and it fits right there, so you really can't get the orientation of the reverse gear incorrect. Once again, just gonna put it in the box. And now we've come to the best part of all. Now, to actually work on either one of these shafts, we have to take both of them out along with the shift fork. So we actually have to lift all of that out at once. We're gonna set it down over here on the pad. And then what we'll do is we'll bring the counter shaft back over here and use the casing as a stand so that we can work on it. So we have to lift all five of these pieces up at once. I'm just gonna cover it with a rag because it's all slippery. But what I'm gonna do is grab the shift forks and the two gear sets together. It should lift out just like that. All right, so do the rag here. Take this one, roll it over, pull these shift forks out of the way. We're gonna lift this counter shaft back up. Do not tip it over. So now we're gonna go ahead and just place it back where it was. Okay, so here's the main shaft, and what we gotta do is we have to replace the third gear synchronizer. But just to show you what everything is, this is actually first gear down here. This piece is actually for reverse, so it's got the straight cut teeth. And it's because of the straight cut teeth that you can actually hear the car move, where you hear that sound like, that's this noise right here, because the straight cut teeth. This is second gear, third gear, fourth gear, and fifth gear. These are the selectors for third and fourth, and this one is for fifth and reverse, basically. So what we're gonna do is just deconstruct this each piece at a time so you don't get too scared. Now, the easiest way to do that, I'm gonna show you, to replace the third gear synchro, is that to work on the third gear synchro, if you notice, it's underneath here. So I'm gonna shift this collar up, technically into fourth gear. Okay. Now, we actually wanna have this in neutral, so I'm gonna, there we go, put it in neutral. So now we've got it in neutral, and the way you can tell is that you can see this brass ring for fourth gear, and this brass ring for third gear underneath there. Now this one is the one we need to change. The easiest way to do that is to literally lift everything off of the shaft from this synchronizer up. And that's the easiest way to do that if you don't want to get confused or, you know, make a mistake. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna try to grab that. All right, so we're gonna lift with two hands everything off and set it down behind here. Okay, now you've seen I've lifted everything off and I've just set it down right here from that synchro up. On the other shaft, you have to undo a nut, but this one we don't, luckily. One of the things that we're going to replace is this ring, because once it starts grinding, it really struggles to basically, you know, work. The way we have to do that is we have to get this piece off. Now I'm gonna show you something that seems kind of scary, but these shafts are super strong, all right? I mean, they take all the power that you give it in it during its life. So what we're about to do to it is not gonna hurt it. But what I'm going to do is lift this out. I'm gonna come over to the padded section and I'm going to turn it upside down, all right? See that? I'm gonna take it, turn it upside down, put it on the padded section, and I'm gonna drop it off because we have to get this piece right here off. So one, just like that, one knock. So now we're gonna leave that there. We're gonna lift this up and put this back in the shaft where it was. Now we're going to come over here to the third gear. This is third gear, it's actually upside down. What we're gonna do is we're going to take the gear off. And then this is a needle bearing that sits on the inside of it. We'll just set it back over here. And now we have the synchronizer inside the ring. Now we're gonna lift the synchronizer out. Just lay that over here. All right, now we have these two pieces together that are separate, but it's kind of, there we go. Now we should be able to lift this off. Now, a lot of times when your third gear synchronizer, let's take a look at that. Now you may not be able to tell, but on this synchronizer, it's pretty chewed up. But synchronizers usually do get chewed up pretty badly. But one of the things that will sometimes happen is that sometimes this little snap ring will break. You can see that comes off. But usually when that's grinding for a while and real bad, it starts damaging this, which is the selector. So we're gonna replace both of those, these two pieces today. That's what we're gonna replace. Okay, to start this process, we're actually gonna take this needle bearing here in the third gear. We're gonna put that on first. It goes all the way down here, where third gear goes. Then we're gonna take third gear, and remember it actually faces this way when you put it on. So we're gonna put that on. All right, make sure everything's nice and smooth, spinning nice and free. Now you can see here that there's splines. Well, that's what this is for. This is actually the piece that locks to the shaft, and then this ring comes over and grabs the teeth on the gear and this thing at the same time, locking that gear to the shaft. And of course, so it doesn't crunch too much, that's where the synchronizer comes in. Okay, school time, kids. So why do the gears grind? Well, a lot of people say when the gears start grinding, it's because the synchros go bad, which is this. But why is that? Well, I'm about to show you why that is if the camera, you know, really gets it good. This piece here is the main shaft that selects between the gears. And the synchro sits in between them, okay? See the spins? And what this does is that this piece, it goes on top here, but it has this ring outside of it going down for third, up for fourth. And what happens is as these teeth in here go down against these teeth here, what happens is little pieces of brass basically break off. And they use brass because it's a soft metal. And that's why they also have a magnet at the bottom of the transmission. So yeah, by the way, there's a magnet right here. Make sure that's clean. But what that magnet is for is to catch the shavings that come down over time. But when people shift hard and basically abuse the transmission, what happens is those little pieces of brass getting stuck inside here. Like you can see these scratches and gouges. I don't know if you can. What that's from is little pieces of brass building up on these teeth and grinding them back and forth on this. And that's, you know, why you need to change your manual transmission fluid. You know, when you do this, you definitely need to think about cleanliness. I've actually brake cleaned, you know, some of these for the most part. So here's our old synchro and ring right here. And here's our new synchro and ring. I'm gonna show you how this goes on, and it's pretty easy. Don't be afraid. It can only go back one way. So if you make a mistake, you know, the casing won't close or anything like that. But the first thing that we're gonna do here is we're gonna take our old selector and synchro and put it away so that we don't get confused. We have our new synchronizer and there's a snap ring that goes around it. And this actually pops around it. Okay, you can see that snap ring there. Now what we're going to do is place the synchronizer on the gear. It's nice and clean. Okay, make sure they spin nice. Now we have to put this on. We have to put this on first for this transmission. And the reason why is because of when you put this on, these teeth have to line up. But I'm gonna show you an easy trick of how to do that. So what we're going to do is we're gonna take this ring, we're gonna find the little orientation marks right there. We're gonna face those down. So we're gonna face those down. Then we're gonna take these orientation marks. We're gonna orientate that there. Okay, should just drop right in like that. Now, if you lift this up, it won't go down any further because it's got stoppers. It'll come out that way, which is not good. Okay, so drop it in there. We lift it up. Now we're gonna place this. Now we're gonna make sure these little keyways right here on the synchronizer line up with those teeth right there. So we're gonna drop this down over top of it. And once you get this thing on here, push that down on a little more. Close this down all the way. There we go. So now that's all lined up the way it should be. Now we can take this, click it down in the third gear. It works. Pop it back up, click it back down. Now third gear synchronizer is replaced. Now the easiest thing to do at this point is to literally lift all of these up and just drop them over the shaft, making sure. Okay. Now when you get here, as you drop it down, it obviously needs to sit in these little slots here. So we're just gonna spin it until it drops right down. Now we have another one up here. Gonna make sure, line it up, drops right down. Now this thing, this is like an orientation keyway for the bell housing, for the top of the casing. So you gotta make sure that those lock into these teeth here. All right, place the bearing on it. And voila, you're done. You can check all the gears and synchros by putting your hand on the top of this. Lift up, all right, push down, pop in the middle. Same thing, fourth gear, neutral, third. And that's how you do it. But in case you missed it, if you've gotten all these different gears and everything out of order, I'll actually put it on one by one so you can watch this as a tutorial for that. I'm gonna put each piece on this individually. I'm gonna take the fourth gear synchronizer, place it on where those teeth line up right there. Okay, put the synchronizer on. Then we put needle bearing on. Then we put fourth gear on. And it all just sits on there. Now we're going to put like a spacer collar on. Slide it in there, lines everything up. Then we're gonna put another needle bearing on. Then of course, what comes next, kids? What comes next? You know it, it's fifth gear. Okay, that slides right on. And then of course, fifth gear synchronizer. Now the fifth gear lock ring here. Gonna make sure that lines up there and it drops down and it's connected to teeth right there, so should be good. Next is like a big fat washer with another needle bearing that goes on top of that. Okay, now this might be the tricky part because when you go to put this ring on for fifth gear, it doesn't have the little stoppers on it. So what you have to do is find the teeth that stick out the farthest and they lock into, if you look, teeth that go into the deepest. So you kind of hover this over it and kind of spin it until you get it lined up. Boom. So the last synchronizer goes on. Remember to orientate the slots so they fit right there. And then of course the ring topper here I guess I don't know what to call it. Then the keyway locks into place. And finally, the bearing with the words facing up. And that is it. Now, before we lift this out, because we have to put this whole thing back together, to do that, we have to take this back out and put both gear shafts and all three shift forks in all at the same time. But before we lift this out, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make sure that this selector is in neutral and that this one is in neutral as well. So you can see they're both sitting there perfectly. Now, I'm gonna lift this out, and there's a couple washers right there. I leave them there. The one that kind of bounces is concave, faces up. So now I'm gonna very carefully set this right next to the other one. So first and second are on this shaft. Each gear actually has two gears put together, and that's what makes the ratio. So I'm gonna put the forks on. These little divots right here face up. The shortest one goes on the first one here. The second tallest one on this one here. And the third one over here. Now I'm gonna have to grab all of these and drop it in there all at once. We're gonna come over here, drop them in all at once. A little tricky. And once they're all dropped in, you need to make sure that all three of these are in neutral. Okay, so in the best, easiest way to do this, put one finger underneath, make sure they all line up the same. Now you're gonna come to this little keyway here, and that needs to face up. It needs to point at that bolt hole, basically. It needs to stay right about there. Just like when we took it apart, we're gonna do everything in reverse. We're gonna put the shift selector in first. When we put the shift selector in, we're going to remove the bolts that we had in it. Now we have to fit this guy in here. And when we do that, we have to lift this up with a finger. I don't know if you can see, but I'm gonna lift this up with my finger and basically slide this guy in here. This is probably the most pain part to put in. A little tricky. There we go. So now we got it in there. I'm gonna kind of line these holes up, put the screws in. Remember, the gold one goes here. I'm gonna hand thread that in there, make sure the threads thread in there nice. Of course, this one. Now, once again, when we go to put this screw in here, it's kind of a pain, so put it on a magnet. We're gonna get it down in there. Put it in the hole. There we go. Thread it in there. And now we're gonna tighten these guys very lightly. Snug. Snug. It's very important that these are only 10 millimeter bolts and they do not need to be that tight. Now we're gonna put the reverse in. Remember that the keyway faces down and the screw hole faces up. Orientate it there. Should just drop in. Okay, and finally the reverse gear selector, which is this guy. Got the two bolts over here. We're gonna set this over here. Then we're gonna lift up the reverse gear and fit that little claw over it like that. Now we're gonna get a bolt in here and thread it. Same thing. And thread it, not too tight, just snug. You don't want them loose, but. Now there's one thing that we have to do before we go to close this transmission up, and that is, ta-da, to get a razor blade or whatever and clean the surface. We gotta get all this gasket out because we have to put a new gasket in. So I've gotta get busy with a razor blade, scraping all this old RTV off. I'll be back in a second. You don't really need to see that. Now, I've gone and scraped the surface of the transmission, and when you scrape the old RTV off, try not to let it fall into the trans. You can see I've put a fresh bead of RTV around it. Trick is to go inside of the bolt holes and do not get the RTV in the bolt holes, or they can actually cause the metal to break and split and explode. Actually, I've seen that. So what we're going to do is drop the case on, wiggle the shift selector, and hopefully the case should drop right on. Clean up the bottom of the casing. So now we're going to place it over the top ever so slightly. Be very careful, kind of wiggle it on. Okay, so we'll drop it till about there. Now we need to drop it a little bit more. The way to do that is we take their screwdriver and we pull the shift selector back and forth. Some pressure on it. There we go.
Now the case is closed.
And now we have to do the trick of spreading this open and popping it up with a flathead screwdriver. Take the flathead screwdriver, we're gonna reach in here and grab, put it underneath the nut, lift up, and voila, she pops into place, and the little C-ring is now locked into that little clip. Now we need to put this cap on and all the 12 millimeter bolts. Now we're gonna take a little cap. You do not need to use sealant on this. That can cause these to crack. Make sure you get it threaded in there properly. And do not over tighten this bolt or it will crack the casing. I'm gonna put a half inch wrench on it. Get to where it's snug. Get it snug. Not too tight. Okay, now for a 14 millimeter bolt that goes right here. Hand thread that in, that's for the reverse gear. Okay, now the detents, we're gonna take a little ball bearing, place it in here. Second ball bearing, place it inside. We're gonna take our 12 millimeter with the spring and washer, hand thread that. Our second 12 millimeter bolt and spring, hand thread that in there. Snug, do not over tighten. And ladies and gentlemen, that is it. Now the last thing to do is to get this set on its side and check the shaft. Now we place the transmission down, grab the shaft, make sure it spins nice and free. And that's pretty much it, guys. Do not be afraid to do this. It's very simple. Just have some patience, take your time, stay organized, be clean about it. But for the most part, these transmissions are very tough. The brass synchros are a little weak, but other than that, they're really tough. But they're not that hard to work on. So unfortunately, I had to go back to my old camera this time. Didn't have the other camera. So thank you guys again for tuning in. Hopefully this video helped you how to work on your B-Series transmission. We'll see you in the next episode. Remember to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. I hope this video helped everybody. Thank you guys so much for the support. We'll see you in the next video. Peace.